They stand nicely. They're racing. And it was from the inside, Sunlit Fresco, the first to get going over I'm a Wild Girl. Diamond Light had plenty of early dash as well. It's a line of three at the completion of 200. Right behind them, Pavliani outside. Stevie's May improving. They're being followed further back by Amali Miss down on the inside next of all. And now around the outside of it is Born to Be Lucky going up there, the grey, followed by Akaya Kuma. Further back is Magna Sheen. Platinum Class well back in the field with only the one behind it, the rank outside of Millie Jane. They put the 600 behind them. Sunlit Fresco, the chestnut here with the white blaze, leads narrowly approaching the home corner. Sunlit Fresco a half to three quarters of a length in front from Diamond Light, who wanted to hang noticeably on one rein coming around the turn. Then two lengths, Stevie May sneaking up just behind those in front of I'm a Wild Girl. Amali Miss, Platinum Class, is getting room right over on the inside, but Sunlit Fresco let down, dropped them off, kicked away at the 175, Sunlit Fresco. Here comes Amali Miss out of the ruck very quickly. Amali Miss grabbed them, and right down the outside is Magna Sheen. It's Amali Miss, however, and Amali Miss pulls away, wins it from Magna Sheen. Now getting up for third, the other of the greys, Born to Be Lucky from Akaya Kuma, Platinum Class, Pavliani. Sunlit Fresco did not give a yelp, kick clear, and was gone in an absolute twinkling of an eye. Followed by Stevie's May, Diamond Light, I'm a Wild Girl gave nothing, and back there last home, the rank outsider, Millie Jane. Amali Miss is the winner, number eight, ridden by Clint Johnston Porter for the Adam Durant Stable. The daughter of Dash for Cash, Amali Miss, at her sixth career start. She posts her second win, beating Magna Sheen, Born to Be Lucky. We wait on the official placings. They will read 8-5-11 and Akaya Kuma, number 7, weighing in fourth placing. The interim numbers 8-5-11 and 7 after the fourth for the day. Second up, Amali Miss by Dash for Cash for Vicky and Jeff Durant out of Amali Moo, prepared by Adam Durant and Clint Johnston Porter there in the saddle. She's gone around to double figures and proven too good. Magna Sheen like the winner, second up as well. For Neville Parnham, a lean machine filly from Magnus Missile, Luke Campbell, and Born to Be Lucky at any old odds. This has got to the line very well. The grey, there were a couple in the race. She's by Bradbury's Luck from Born Princess for Kirsten Mellis. MJ Rowe, prepared by Kirsten Mellis and written by Chanel Cooper. Adds a little bit of luster into the exotics. In fact, the pick four is going to pay over 21,000. 8-5-11 and 7 they are. And a half a length of neck are the margins in 1-13-4-7, 36.15. Well, Sunlit Fresco, Brad Parnham gave it a dig. It raced about 2.5 in front after they'd straightened. And no sooner had it established the lead, it was Gonski. Sunlit Fresco, it folded up terribly in the last little bit and has been beaten well out of the money after travelling like a winner at the top of the straight. So Amali Miss proves a bit too good for them here at a second run in the campaign to take out the key clean handicap. Platinum Class, she was on the back up, found plenty of room along the cutaway, and she just battled away behind them. Not far off those, but she just can't break through back into the winner's list. Race 5, the Unite Resourcing Handicap over 1,200. Now the Colts and Geldings get their chance at Class 1 level. They'll go at 3 o'clock. No changes there. Lockie Taylor's down in the yard. Let's join him after the victory of Amali Miss.
Thanks, Darren. Really nice win. Second up from Amali Miss. Jason Miller is representing the stable at the moment, and he's just catching up with Lucy Fury, his own runner in Stevie's May, but he now catches up with me. Jace, Amali Miss, that was a nice win. 14 back to 1,200 metres. What have you and Adam learnt about this filly between last start and today to suggest that coming back in trip slightly would be the winning move?
Yeah, we thought she'd run a bit of a race. Like, first up, she was just underdone. That race has brought her on, and dropping back, she ran through the line strong, and yeah, she's come on a lot.
With the right run throughout today, it looks like she's a mare that has a nice little turn of foot.
No, she's lovely little mare, got a good turn of foot, and yeah, she did a good job. She's nice and strong.
Two more runners for Adam in Kia Ora 3? Two or three?
Two.
Two in Kia Ora Te Tau and Alma Money. Who's the best of the remaining pair?
both were really good runs. Kiora, he was really good last start. Drawn a little bit tricky, but they are running on, so I think that should suit him. And All My Money made up really good ground at Bunbury on a tricky track. So, yeah, I think both really good winning chances.
Well done here, and good luck for the remainder of the day.
Thank you.
There's Jason Miller representing the Adam Durant Yard, and here's Clint catching up with Scotty.
Clint Johnson Porter joins me now. Clint, it looked like she got a lovely run through from barrier number one and was able to get out and around heels rather than waiting for that cutaway.
Yeah, definitely. She's an honest little mare. Even back when I won her at Geraldton, she having her first race start, she bashed through them, and just she's so professional and does it so good.
You weren't available first up, but it looked like when you trialled her that she was trialling quite nicely.
Yeah, she was. I think she was a little bit fat still going into her first up run, and even today she probably peaked that last 50, so I think there's improvement from today on.
What about later on? Kisses from Kelly looks like a nice ride.
Yeah, it's a good pickup ride, and hopefully I can get the job done.
Congratulations, well done.
Yeah, thank you.
There's Clint Johnson Porter combining with Adam Durant and Amali Miss to take out the Key Clean Handicap. No, you don't have to kiss and tell. 'Cause you're only going